Figures of speech are plainly defined as saying one thing in terms of something else. So what does that mean? Well, it's simple actually. Whenever you say something, but you don't mean it literally, you are using a figure of speech. Let's say you are about to head out to the store and your mother says, "You better take a jacket, it's raining cats and dogs out there." Now, does your mom literally mean animals are falling from the sky? Of course not. Her meaning is that it is raining hard outside. So why doesn't she just say, "Take a jacket, it's raining"? Because figures of speech are meant to clarify and describe in more detail. Rain itself has many different forms. It could be drizzling, sprinkling, misting, or even downpouring. Now, your mother used a figure of speech to clarify that the rain is hard and would probably soak anyone caught in it. So, figures of speech are very useful in giving a more detailed and accurate description. Figures of speech are expressions that depart from the accepted literal sense or from the normal order of words, or in which an emphasis is produced by patterns of sound. There are different types of figures of speech. So the first one, simile. It is a form of figurative language in which a comparison is made between two things which have something in common using the words like and as. Simile is used to describe an item, situation, emotion, or action by comparing it to something else in order to make the statement more creative and artistic. So let us see some examples of simile. He is as brave as a lion. I feel as fresh as a daisy. My life is like an open highway. I am as busy as a bee. Love swells like a Solway. The second type is a metaphor. It is a form of figurative language, and a metaphor is a rhetorical device in which an object, idea, or situation is referred to directly as something it is not. It moves away from referring to something in a literal sense and refers to it as something else in order to create a more imaginative figure of speech and description of something. In short, a metaphor is an implied simile in which the two things are treated as one. Few examples of metaphor: he is my sunshine. Her tears were a river flowing down her cheeks. You are such a chicken. The dancer was a swan. The snow was a blanket. So the comparison is done directly. The third type is called personification. It is when human characteristics are attributed to an inanimate object. So in a personification, human qualities are given to non-living objects. Few examples: the stars were dancing playfully in the sky. Time and tide wait for none. The car was suffering. The wind screamed through the forest. Opportunity knocks the door. So all the human qualities are given to a non-living thing. And such a type of figure of speech is called as personification. The next type is alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of a speech sound in sequence of words. And the best example for alliterations are the tongue twisters. And it is also known as the head rhyme or initial rhyme. So we'll see some examples now. I have heard how hedgehogs hawk the hedge. She sells seashells by the seashore. Steve saved 7 seagulls. Kukatu cooks crazy cold crocodiles. So all the examples of tongue twisters are examples of
alliteration. The next type is anaphora. It is a figure of speech in which the same word or phrase is repeated in the beginning of the lines or sentences. For example, I came, I saw, I conquered. I is repeated. In the next example, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times, it was the age of wisdom. It was the is repeated. Mad world, mad kings, mad composition. 5 years, 5 summers, 5 long winters.